What we have here is the House Budget Committee, Republican majority, putting out yet again a budget that addresses America's needs, a budget that balances the budget. It's a path to prosperity, a responsible, balanced budget. We believe that we owe the American people a balanced budget. And for the third straight year, we've delivered. In fact, we balanced this budget in just 10 years. This is a document, a plan that balances the budget in 10 years. Now, the House Budget Committee has spent the last several weeks working together with each other, just like families and businesses do around the country. We've been assembling a budget so that we can make sure that our country can live within its means. It's a reasonable goal, balancing the budget. And we keep spending money. We can't just keep spending money we don't have. That's the basic acknowledgement when you're budgeting, just like families and businesses do, that you cannot continue to kick the can down the road, that you cannot continue to spend money we just don't have. Now, how do we do this? We cut wasteful spending. We repair the safety net so that we can help those in need. We protect and strengthen key priorities like Medicare, a program that's going bankrupt, that's jeopardizing the health security for millions of American seniors. And we foster a healthier economy so that we can create jobs and grow more wages. You see, balancing the budget is not simply an act of arithmetic, not just getting expenditures and revenues to add up. Balancing the budget is a means to an end. It's a means to a healthier economy, a pro-growth society, a pro-growth economy that delivers opportunity. That is first and foremost why we are doing this. Now, let me walk through a few of the charts, if I could. And if this thing works, there we go. Now, here is essentially what we do to begin with. This budget cuts spending by $4.6 trillion over the next 10 years. Historically, we've paid a little less than one-fifth of our income to the federal government, but the government has historically paid a lot more, spent a lot more. We match revenues with expenditures. So our budget matches the spending with our income, just like every family and business must do throughout America. In fact, we bring our deficits down right away. This shows you how our deficit path goes down precipitously to begin with, to the point where we end up with a surplus in 2023. Now, in the 1990s, Democratic president worked with a Republican Congress to balance the budget. This is a goal that both parties have been able to achieve consensus on achieving in the past. We think it's something we ought to do again. Number three, this is the picture that should scare everybody. This is the picture that shows you the path we are on today. We know, without a shred of doubt, we are consigning the next generation to an inferior standard of living. We know, just like in Europe, we are facing a debt crisis in this country. And a debt crisis hurts everybody. But the people who a debt crisis hurts the most are the poor, the elderly, the people who need government the most. They're the ones who get hurt the first and the worst in a debt crisis. And so what are we doing? We are addressing the most predictable economic crisis in this country's history, this coming debt. The red line shows you the path that this country is on right now. The green line shows you the debt reduction path that we achieve by putting this budget into law. Not only will we balance the budget, we will pay off our debt so that we give our children a debt-free nation. And doing that helps grow our economy as well. At this time, I'd like to turn over to one of the distinguished members of the Budget Committee, who's one of our Ways and Means designees. He's going to talk about some of our pro-growth economic policies. Please know that by balancing the budget, we grow the economy. By including pro-growth reforms like tax reform, we're making it easier for businesses to plan, to invest, to create jobs, to be competitive. We want more jobs, higher wages, families getting out of poverty into the middle class. And that is one of the cornerstone policies we have in here is tax reform. And let me turn it over to Diane Black to explain exactly what we're doing.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Our budget is an opportunity to change the course of our nation. We have a responsibility to avoid the debt crisis, as the chairman has already said, and to move forward with a prosperous future. Now, common sense and math tell us that balancing a budget requires two things: cutting spending and economic growth. A huge obstacle right now to this is our complicated tax code. Today, the tax code is nearly 4 million words long, and about 60% of our taxpayers need to hire a professional to help them to prepare their returns. Every year, Americans spend 6 billion hours and $160 billion filling out their returns. Clearly, something is wrong. Now, our budget paves the way for tax reform, and it reaffirms that the Ways and Means Committee will pass comprehensive pro-growth tax reform legislation this year. Now, this budget builds on bipartisan consensus in favor of lowering the rates to create jobs and broadening the base to ensure fairness and simplicity for our families. The purpose of tax reform is not to take more money from our families to spend more money here in Washington. It's to create jobs and to increase the wages for our working families. I look forward to working with my budget members and also the Ways and Means Committee to advance comprehensive tax reform this year to help us to strengthen our economy, reduce our deficit, and get Americans back to work. Thank you.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to turn the podium over to the Vice Chairman of the Budget Committee, Dr. Tom Price from Georgia.
Thank you, Paul, so much. You know, budgets are about priorities, and priorities that the American people overwhelmingly support include getting federal spending under control, getting our economy moving again so that folks can get back to work, and getting our debt crisis under control so that we may preserve the American dream for future generations. These are precisely the priorities that are incorporated within our Path to Prosperity, our budget. This Path to Prosperity is the way to a responsible, balanced budget. American families all across this great land know that the federal government shouldn't spend more than it takes in, and we agree. Sadly, the budgets proposed by President Obama have never, ever, ever gotten to balance. The legal deadline for the president to present his budget to Congress this year was February 4th. It's now March 12th. And past experience tells us that when he does bring his budget, that one won't balance likely either. American families can't live this way, and neither should the federal government. Republicans believe that people work too hard to have the federal government take more of their money to spend more here in Washington. We want the American people to keep more of their hard-earned money to save and to spend and to invest as they see fit. Now, Senate Democrats, on the other hand, haven't adopted a budget in nearly 4 years. They'll do one this year because of the No Budget, No Pay Act that was passed in the House earlier this year. Will they continue to say that we need more taxes to chase ever-increasing spending? The truth is that they can't ever tax the American people enough to pay for their skyrocketed levels of spending that they want. Now, we look forward to seeing their budget. The next test will be whether or not they can pass the budget that they introduce. Will enough Senate Democrats be willing to endorse a plan that taxes more so that Washington can spend more? That Washington way simply isn't working. The American people are sick and tired of political games being played with our economy, where special interests and backroom deals seem to dominate policymaking. Our plan, the House Republican budget, finally puts a stop to that, so Washington uses hard-earned tax dollars in an accountable and an effective way. Now, we wonder, will the White House and Senate Democrats be able to say the same thing about their budgets? Or will we just see more accounting tricks and budget gimmicks and wasteful spending? This path to prosperity, this budget here, will create a healthier economy where job creators are hiring, job seekers are finally finding more jobs, more work, and more American families and entrepreneurs are realizing their dreams. This path to prosperity ensures that we are honoring the commitments that Americans' most important priorities. Our budget saves and strengthens Medicare, protects our national security, cares for the poor and sick by repairing America's safety net programs, and expands economic opportunity for every single American. Republicans will protect these vital programs while we will control spending and solve our nation's debt crisis. Our hope is that Democrats see these vital programs as something that they want to save and strengthen, not simply to demagogue. We believe in the industriousness, in the ingenuity, and the American dreams of the American people. It's time that the government starts acting worthy of the people that we represent. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Price. This is not only a responsible, reasonable, balanced plan, it's also an invitation. This is an invitation to the President of the United States, to the Senate Democrats, to come together to fix these problems. We don't think it's fair to let critical programs like Medicare go bankrupt. We don't think that it's fair to take more from hardworking families to spend more in Washington. The most important question isn't how we balance the budget, but why. A budget is a means to an end. An end is the well-being of the American people. An end is a growing economy that produces opportunity and upward mobility. A balanced budget will help provide the kind of economic security we need for families. It will help secure retirement for our seniors, and it will help expand opportunity for young people who have a hard time finding careers and jobs in this stagnant economy. Now, the final point I want to make is, and I mentioned this to the president the other day, we want to revive the budget process so that we have regular order. What does that mean? That means let's do our jobs. That means we want to pass a budget here in the House. We're very pleased that the Senate is going to pass a budget, or is going to at least attempt to pass a budget. What that means is we're reviving a process that's not in the back room, but that shows how we're going to accomplish these goals. We want to revive this budget process so at the end of the day, we can have a vehicle to actually get something done. And I don't think the president disagrees with that. And so this is an invitation. Show us how to balance the budget. If you don't like the way we're proposing to balance our budget, how do you propose to balance the budget? Are we going to continue to be complicit with never, ever balancing our budget and therefore guaranteeing an inferior standard of living to the next generation? We know that this debt and this deficit is hurting our economy today and destroying the future tomorrow. This is a specific plan to show how to get it under control. It's our vision for a pro-growth, upward mobile society. And the final point I would make is this. Far too long in Washington, we measure success of our efforts by inputs. How much money are we spending on these programs? Rather than measuring success by outputs, are they working? We have put so much money into our welfare programs, into our poverty-fighting programs, yet we have 46 million people living in poverty. It's among the highest rates of poverty we've had in a generation. So rather than measure how much money are we spending in these programs, let's think about measuring, are we helping people? Are we getting people out of poverty? Are we getting people back on their feet again into lives of self-sufficiency and upward mobility, of dignity? These are the kinds of questions that we're tackling in this budget. And as we do this, we're showing the country a plan to balance the budget, to grow the economy, to get people out of poverty, to get the American dream reignited, especially for those people who have seemingly seen it slip away from them.